Hello, everyone. Welcome to today's presentation by the Quad City Symphony Orchestra Percussion Section. They've chosen a number of really fun pieces to play for you today, and they would really love to show you their instruments. But before we get started, can you take out a sheet of paper, or your laptop, I suppose, and I want you to jot down a few thoughts about what you already know about percussion instruments and how they make sound. I'll be back at the end of the performance to tell you what to do next. Enjoy the show.
We'll be right back. Hi. Percussion is really fun. Lots of times what we do is we establish a groove or a rhythm that creates a beat that keeps the group that we're playing with going. Sometimes what we do is we create sound effects that also add life to the music that we're playing in, and that allows us to use lots of different instruments. I'm going to demonstrate for you today three of the different instruments that I played in the video that you're about to see, and two of them are very familiar to you. They're used quite often. This is the bass drum, and I've got a towel on it because bass drums can sound like thunder, or they can sound like giant fireworks, or they just sound like thuds. And in the song that I played, I had to be careful and use several different mallets. I used a mallet that was soft, I used a mallet that was very hard, and then I used some mallets that did double duty. I could play fast, and I had to reach over and hit a cymbal. So percussionists use lots and lots and lots of different implements to hit with. The bass drum, of course, is the booming one. But if I want it to be really thumpy, I dry it up with the towel. And if I want it to be really sharp sounding, you can tell the difference. The really fun thing is I've got a couple little things here. Once in a while we do sound effects. These kind of look like lollipops. And they're really kind of fun because if you rub them on an instrument, it kind of makes them cry. Or sound like a lion. Depends on the instrument. So this is the bass drum. This is what we call another one of the cymbals in the cymbal family. We call it a suspended cymbal. And in one of the videos that you'll watch, you'll see me hit it, and you'll also see me roll on it. And for those of you that are percussionists, when you roll it at the edges of the cymbal, not in the same place. And it can create quite a loud sound. These instruments here, this is the bongos. And I got to play bongos on two of the pieces that we played today. And lots of times you'll see people play bongos with their hands. But I had to play so fast and so loud that I used sticks. It was really fun, very busy. And I hope in the audio that you heard, you could pick up on the bongo sound. So when you listen to the videos, watch for all of us and see if you can pick out which instruments you saw demonstrated and if you can hear them in the recording. Now, for this last little demonstration, as I said, percussionists love to play sound effects. And if any of you have ever seen the movie Harry Potter or Star Wars, there's all kinds of sounds and eerie sounds and scary sounds and exploding sounds, and many of those come from the percussion section. I'll have to take my mask off to play a couple of them because these are the fun ones that I brought along with today. Every once in a while, we have to play sounds from daily life, like a police car. That's always kind of fun. And then every once in a while, percussionists have the reputation of being kind of crazy. Hope you enjoyed this. Thank you.
Hi everybody. There are all kinds of drums that we use in the percussion section, and there are things like snare drum and bass drum, some of the typical instruments that you see at any band or orchestra concert. But from time to time, we use all sorts of other drums, and this is one of them. These are the timbales. It's a traditional instrument. It has a little bit different sound than the snare drum. Sometimes you might hear traditional patterns. Or you just might hear rhythms played on the drums without any sort of regard to traditions. That's the timbales. One of the instruments percussionists play a lot are cymbals. And if you go to a band or orchestra concert, you might see crash cymbals. But here I have a set of cymbals that are on a stand, and these are called hi-hat cymbals. You'll sometimes see these when somebody's playing drum set, you know, maybe at a rock concert, something like that. But we also use them in just in the regular percussion section in a band or orchestra piece. And I play the cymbals using my hands on the cymbals here, but I can also use my feet. So let me demonstrate both of those. So I'm going to close, and now I can play with my hand. But I can also use my feet. And that time I did both. I used my hands and my feet. So this is the hi-hat. Another interesting and fun thing about the percussion section is you get to play things that aren't things that most people think of as percussion instruments. In this case, I have an instrument that's actually a car part. This is a brake drum, called for by composers a lot these days. So it's something that most people wouldn't think, hey, I'm going to hit that and make a sound. But you have to remember, anything you can hit and make a musical sound is a percussion instrument. So here is the brake drum, taken straight from a car, and now I'm playing it as a musical instrument. Or, I brought these from my house, doing some work. These are sandpaper blocks. And now it's a musical instrument. So we get to play all sorts of different things like this.
cymbals, discs of metal, come in many different sizes. In fact, the comparison we often make, because it's a nice snowy day, is that they're like snowflakes in that no two are alike. These are very small cymbals, ideally suited to marches, which is what we'll play for the demonstration. Let's hear them a little bit. Very bright, they ring a long time. You'll notice that occasionally I do odd effects, such as jam them together, we call that a crunch, or imitate the hi-hat that Tony demonstrated. Those are the small cymbals. They come in so many different sizes, I think it's time to hear the large ones. At major points of impact in symphonic works, the cymbal player will prepare, position, and then all eyes are on the cymbal player. Even by itself, it's a wonderful moment. Vibraphone is the cousin of Glockenspiel, otherwise known as bells, and chimes in that it's made of metal, but it's really a closer cousin to the marimba. It's just that it's made of metal. It also has an interesting feature in that it's got fans inside the tubes, which we call resonators, and I'll run it with my hand here because I'm not plugged in with electricity that normally makes them run. That's where the name vibraphone comes from, because it's got vibrato. It's a lovely instrument, often used in jazz. Four mallets. Timpani is the Italian name for kettle drums. It's the king of instruments, surely. In that I mean it's the original percussion instrument used in the symphony orchestra. It's the one I play most often. Played with many different sets of mallets, from the very softest to slightly harder. Are the hardest and most colorful. Originally, there would be tuning handles all the way around the instrument. It would be tuned by hand, which takes a long time. So the pedal, which facilitates quick tuning, is just such an advantage. And occasionally, comedic effects such as glissando, which means slide, are used, and the very hardest of beaters. Timpani. Thank you.
In the percussion section, we use a variety of drums, hundreds of options for us to choose from. Some drums we play with sticks or mallets, some drums we play with our hands. And every drum that we play has its own distinct name. For instance, this drum right here is one that we use probably the most frequently. This is the snare drum. And you might wonder, well, why exactly do they call it the snare drum? Well, that's because on the bottom of this drum, you see these wires here, these metal wires, and we call those snares, so that when we play the drum, we hit the top head, it sends the air down, it vibrates against the bottom head, and it rattles the snares to give it its distinct sound. And when the snares are on and we play the drum, we get this sound, which you're probably familiar from hearing possibly in parades and in concerts. But the neat thing about the snare drum, there's a switch on the back, and if I turn it off, I can also turn off the snares and we get a whole nother sound. That's the snare drum. I'm standing behind the marimba, which is the largest of the four main mallet instruments that we use in the orchestra. If you come to an orchestra concert or band concert, you'll often see the marimba or the xylophone or the vibraphone or the glockenspiel. Sometimes we call the glockenspiel bells. The ways to tell the instruments apart, the vibraphone and the glockenspiel have metal bars, and the marimba and the xylophone both have wood bars. But how do you tell the marimba from the xylophone? Well, it comes down to the size. You can often identify the marimba because it's larger, but also what it sounds like. The xylophone has a much higher pitch and a much harder attack to the sound, and the marimba has a softer sound, a warmer sound, has more resonance. And these pipes that you see on the front of the instrument that people often call the pipes or the tubes, those are called resonators, and those help give the marimba its distinctive sound. And here's a little bit of what the marimba sounds like.
Thank you.
Remember that sheet of paper? Let's flip it over and write down a few thoughts about what you know now about percussion instruments. See how much you've learned? Well, I hope you have a great rest of your day, and we get to see you soon.